Quranic verses came in gradual order. It was not a book which was lectured down by someone in a series of classes at universities, or it was not a book which was written by someone and was published in the publishing house and was available after that to the readers to read. Quran was a book, a divine scripture, which came by gradual order so that people could learn the implications and applications of the verses by circumstances so that it could take effect permanently in human societies. And it was to be interpreted and made inferences from the examples of lives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his sahabas, his tabi'in and tabi'ins, and thereafter to be understood by the scholars. Because the Prophet, peace be upon him, described the scholars of Islam as the stars in the sky. Surah 25, verse 32 confirms that the Quran was revealed to the believers in gradual progression so that the followers' faith could be increased and the followers' faith could be established. You read the verse and find out for yourself. Law does not have any retrospective effect, that we all know, that you enact a law, it will not affect someone who did something before the law came into force. So it is called retrospective effect. So the law does not have, cannot have retrospective effect. This is one of the equitable principles of law. Prophet Muhammad, when he gave the Quran to the people, he implemented the instructions of the Quran in gradual order so that there was no rebellion, there was no outright rejection, because people were used to many things which predated Islam's instruction, so that people could have to be given a time to adjust. This is a great thing to learn as well from history, because if you want to implement something outright, then dictatorial rule will be implemented. That's not the way to implement a law which people should accept voluntarily. Because the Quran says, La ikraha fid din, lakum dinukum waliya din, there is no compulsion in religion. You go your way, we go mine. But a prophet's duty, a person's duty, a follower of the prophet's duty, is to just simply give the message. To change the heart is not the duty of the Prophet. It was not the duty of anyone who really truly believed in Islam ever. So, just to give the message and let it work in their heart. So, imposition was out of the question. So, if the Prophet wanted to give the book, and he had ordered the implementation of the rules straight away, then he would have asked for a dictatorial rule. Surah 16, verse 10, talks about nasq. As we know, the Quranic verses are abrogated. One verse abrogates other, the latter verse abrogates the previous one for various reasons. One, to implement, to wait for the certain time, certain situation where the Quranic rule could be established permanently. The people were given some time to adjust. And the previous verse, if is abrogated also for reasons like that is bad, or that ritual which was allowed before was bad and now it's about time to nullify that. For example, Surah 4 verse 23 talks about the prohibited degrees. You can marry someone and you can cannot marry others. For example, a Muslim cannot marry two sisters together. But if a Muslim man who came to Islam, and before that he was a mushrik or a kafir or a non-believer, and he already had married two sisters together, then he was given leniency. Surah 4 verse 23, read it. But it was not allowed for people who ought to be married after that verse. So you see the leniency. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, adopted Zaid when he was not a Muslim. So if he had brought a rule of adoption regarding adoption after that time when he became a prophet and brought a rule, he shouldn't be bound by the rule which he had brought from Allah afterwards. Because as I said in the beginning, law does not have retrospective effect. In Islam, taking care of the orphans is an order from Allah, because the Prophet himself was an orphan. And if you read Surah Ad-Doha, you will see, like many other verses in Quran, Muslims are instructed to take care of the orphan, because the Prophet himself was an orphan. But whenever you adopt someone as bring in someone as in your household, a child, an orphan, you should never deny that child of his biological origin or his identity regarding biological origin. The right of a biological parent should always be remembered. That's why even in Australia, some time ago, law was enacted so that adopted children could demand to know the details about their biological parents. So in Islam, adopting someone as your own son is not allowed, because this belongs to the biological parents. You can take care of them, but you can give them like love, but you cannot take care of, you cannot treat them or identify to the world them as their own children, because that will deny them of their biological origin. That will deny them of their biological identity. If you take up the name of your adopted parent, that also opens up the loophole of this being abused. Do you remember the name of Malcolm X? Do you know why he had taken the name X? Because he refused to carry the name of his slave master. This what happens. Now, after Muhammad, peace be upon him, married Zaid's wife, the then wife, Zainab. Did Zainab object to it? Was she not interested in marrying the Prophet? Well, give me one law in the world where if adopted son divorces, even if argument's sake, take that you have an adopted son, you have divorced that adopted son, you cannot marry. Is that a law? Laws in the world are enacted on the base of equity. So if it was against equitable principles, then the laws would have banned it in various nations. But laws do not ban it in any nation that I know of. That even if you divorce, even if your son even, forget about adopted son, even if your son even divorces someone, you can marry that person. That's the law. But anyway, Islam doesn't say that, but Islam also says that adoption as a son, denying of the parental biological rights, is not allowed. So Zainab did not object to it. She was rather happy about it. She was rather proud about it, because she was proud. The hadith says that instruction to marry her came to the Prophet in the Quranic verses, Surah 33. Read it. So she was happy. He was happy. Even Zaid was happy to divorce her, because they were not getting along very well. So what is your problem? So Zaid was never an adopted son according to Islam, because Islam doesn't have a retrospective effect, Islamic instructions. And also because they were happy, Zainab was happy, Zaid was happy, and Zaid even gave his last drop of blood for Islamic jihad against the oppressors. So what is your problem? And Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, gave instructions to the people from Quranic verses in gradual order so that people could adopt in time. So this is a miracle rather. So that it is an instruction from came from Allah so that it could take a serious effect on the Islamic society to remember in future. And for the humanity to take heed regarding the biological right of parents.